Dear students, good morning. Let us start the discussion on today's newspaper, that is 23rd May 2018. The first article, the fading appeal of soft power. Here the soft power refers to three things. One is political ideals of India, its civilizational values, and third is cultural resonance. And these three things have guided India's diplomacy from very beginning. So any country which is supposed to win in diplomacy has to balance its soft power with hard power. If we take United States of America, Hollywood reflects its soft power and its military might reflects its hard power. If you go with Russia, it is more a hard power rather than a soft power. If you go to China, its strong cultural values, civilizational strength provides it the necessary soft power. So in this scenario, the Nehruvian era in India was more guided by the soft power, which is centered around normative consensus. Non-aligned movement, Panchashil, all these are meant to reflect this, which are centered around political ideals, values, and strategic autonomy. It means the newly independent countries shall maintain their equidistance from the poles of the world. Now, we appear to be moving away from this. So the normative concerns of our diplomacy are being replaced by the practical considerations, which we call it as real politics. It is reflected in various decisions the government took recently. So let us see it region by region. When you come to South Asia, the SAARC is an India-centric institution, but SAARC was totally undermined for its differences with Pakistan. And the second is, India has interfered with Nepal and did not welcome the Nepal constitution. It has worsened the relations between the countries. And the third thing is, the Doklam standoff also appears to be a show-off of the hard power India wants to take off. It means that India is believing about power and influence are the major guiding factors for the diplomacy. And coming to Rohingya crisis, so India was supposed to warn or else talk to Myanmar about this. Prime Minister Modi, when he visited Myanmar, he did not make any statement related to Rohingya crisis. And then Bangladesh was expecting India to play a role. As India did not take up this, China took the opportunity and mediated between Bangladesh and Myanmar. So it was traditionally a role played by India in diplomacy in its neighborhood. And next thing is, let's go to West Asia. Here, Israel-Palestinian conflict, if we see, India was always sympathetic to the Palestinian cause. But today, India's real politics expects it to be close to Israel to gain military power, to gain defense imports. And at the same time, so with regard to major powers, USA, Russia, so Russia was a friend of India. But today, India has become more close to USA and it is called as major defense partner and also major non-NATO ally of US. And India signed LEMOVA, Logistics Exchange Memorandum of Agreement with US, and more such agreements are going to come up. It means India today is stating that non-alignment to multi-alignment we are moving. So we are not just aligning with the US, we are also aligning with Russia. And if you take the West Asia, we are aligning with Saudi Arabia, Israel, and also with Iran. So it means we are trying to align with all the three poles. This is what is often described as the multi-alignment. In this context, the author, what he says is, Indian foreign policy also need to focus upon its soft power. And this soft power has provided its necessary legitimacy to act as a balance in the international affairs. So if it is concerned about its hard power, probably India may lose leverage on this. This is how author is trying to place it as. The Nipah test, you know that Nipah virus, a paramyxovirus, is causing neurological problems and ultimately the death. So in this context, its reservoir is a bat and it is being spread through pigs. And any exposure to bat fluids is also leading to the cause of disease in humans. In Kerala, there is an epidemic outbreak. What can be the reason? One is habitat loss for the bats. So that's why bats have come close to the human habitations. And second thing is, the overpopulation is also a reason for the spread of the virus so fast. And lack of effective measures to safeguard ourselves, proper hygiene practices, this is the third reason. So if we want to contain the disease, the best thing is protection of the caregivers and strict regimen of hand washing. These are the various techniques. As of now, there is no treatment available. Only possibility is to stop the transmission of the disease. And the disease transmission is only to the primary contacts as of now. Primary contacts with the bats and the deceased person's body fluids. These are the primary contacts who are getting the disease. So it shall not spread to the secondary contacts. That's why we need to contain the disease with proper hygiene and also proper containment techniques. That's how this article talks about. Keeping each other on edge. Recently, judiciary and executive, we saw a lot of fight. In this context, judicial independence has been spoken a lot. So, wherever there is separation of powers between three organs of the government, conflict is inevitable. Or I can put it as friction is inevitable rather than conflict. So this friction leads to innovation, discussion and debate. That's how the democratic institutions evolve. The history has many examples of this kind of behavior. Here he talks about two examples. One is Lord Wolfe, what he stated on this. The three organs of the state are like three chains that hold the structure of the state together. And if one chain weakens, the other two chains have to take the burden onto them. But however, the weakening shall not lead to breaking of the other chain. So there has to be a balance between the three organs. If one of the organ is weakening, the burden will naturally shift towards to the other organ. And this organ regains its position very slowly. And then their balance will be reset again. That's what this article talks about. So remember the point. Whenever there is an imbalance across the institutions, it is a natural evolution that the balance is restored. So we need not worry about the friction that is coming up between the organs of the state. After re-election, so this is about Venezuelan election in which Nicolas Maduro got re-elected. So Nicolas Maduro is the follower of or protege of Hugo Chavez. Hugo Chavez built an economy in Venezuela which is based or dependent on commodity exports. The commodity which they used to export is the oil. So not just the Venezuela, South America, Brazil, and also Chile, all these countries are commodity export based countries. Now, as the commodity prices have dropped, these have pushed these countries into economic crisis. Coming to Venezuela, so Mr. Maduro's election may not be appealing to the West. So the sanctions are expected to move on. Already on a crippling economy, if more sanctions are imposed by US and West, it will lead to a worsening of the situation and it may lead to humanitarian crisis in Venezuela. That is what this article talks. From Indian context, many of the pharma companies like Dr. Reddy's, they have invested abundantly in Venezuela and they are on the verge of losing their forex. We are very interested in joining Exercise Malabar. It's an interview with Julie Bishop, the foreign minister of Australia. So there are two important takeaways. Australia is interested to engage with India. The engagement is expected to be on defense, economic and people-to-people relations. So with regard to this, Australia showed a keen interest to join Malabar exercises into which Japan is an invitee. But however, Australia was not invited by India for the reason that it shall not appear as threatening the China and its rise. So it shall not appear that India is actively involved with containment of China. And second thing is, the relations with Australia, these are expected to take a fast pace as economic engagement and nuclear engagement of India increases with it. India and Australia, though signed the Civil Nuclear Cooperation Agreement, it did not move forward as a commercial agreement. It is soon expected to come into reality. And third, Quad, US, India, Japan and Australia together formed Quad. So this Quad was seen as a containment on China by that country. So in this context, what the foreign minister says, Quad is an extension of already existing trilateral dialogue. So it is USA, Japan, India. These are involved in a trilateral dialogue. Similarly, USA, Japan and Australia involved in trilateral dialogue. So the Quad is nothing but a mix of these two and an extension of these two. These are the important points in this. App will help voters to share malpractice proof. Voters who identify certain malpractices during the elections can record and directly send them to the Election Commission through Model Code of Conduct Violation Reporting App. So, you know, India's Election Commission is on forefront with regard to use of technology. Either it is EVMs, either it is electoral rolls, or with related to the new app. The technology is coming in forefront to provide for or to increase fairness in elections. And if you carefully observe, the Model Code of Conduct was just a moral conduct before. But today, with persuasion, Election Commission is able to bring in Model Code of Conduct for compulsory implementation. That's the victory, moral victory to the Election Commission of India. Small farmers gets raw deal. So among loans given by the banks, there is something called priority sector lending. It means the government declares certain sectors as the priority sectors and the loan has to be given to them. And most important sector in the priority sector lending is agriculture. 18% of the net loans given by the bank shall go to the agriculture. But banks are not much interested to give loans to agriculture for the reason that many populistic programs may target them, may go for loan waivers, which may lead to financial indiscipline, etc. So in this context, to meet these targets, banks are looking for alternative ways. So they try to give for medium and big farmers rather than for small and marginal farmers, the one thing. Rather than in the rural areas, so they try to give loans to the semi-urban areas or else satellite areas which are close to the urban areas. In that way, they want to decrease their risk. So that's why this report of RBI to the Standing Committee of Parliament clearly states that around 40% of the total agricultural loan has reached the small and marginal farmers who constitute more than 90% of our total agricultural community. Police firing claims 10 lives in Tamil Nadu. So it is again Sterlite Industries which has smelting copper smelting plant in Thoothukudi, and people accuse that this plant is the reason for many health problems of the citizens over there. And a protest has started against them. Ultimately, it went out of control and it has led to police firing. So in this context, the mob control and then how to manage protest, these are important questions for your ethics paper. A ceasefire will work only if Pakistan joins it. So ceasefire was announced during Vajpayee government. It was successful. What was the reason? Pakistan reciprocated it. There was pressure from the people for the local militant groups to take up the ceasefire. So in this context, it has been stated, a ceasefire will work only if Pakistan joins it. It means that the Pakistan has to agree it and also local groups shall actively support it. Then only the ceasefire becomes peaceful and also leading to a better conditions of conduct among different parties in Kashmir. That's what Farooq Abdullah says. Global Times slams media report on Chinese mining. You know that on Arunachal Pradesh, along the line of actual control, China is involving with gold mining. This is what the report which has come recently. So now, China opposes the same through its mouthpiece, Global Times. Summit with Kim may be delayed. You know that US is insisting on denuclearization as a precondition for summit. And Mr. Kim is very clear that he is not ready for it. So that's why the summit is expected to be delayed. And then finally, I gave you the notes that is available at laics.in/civilsprep. Thank you very much and all the best.